First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air, no doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories. Shit that works.
No doubt, you're back again with Dr. Eileen Bay. And we're going to go into healing, health, and alternative cures. Let me bring in my co-host, Brother L. Grand Sheik, are you here?
Yes, sir. Brother, peace and love, God.
All right, peace and love, brother. God, how you doing today?
Oh, I'm doing great, brother. Great, brother. How's the brother doing?
Everybody good? We all good? I'm good. You know, be ready for this cruise tomorrow. You know, for those who's missing it, you know, we're going to have to catch y'all the next time. But,
right.
You know, for those that know what we do and send that positive love and energy towards us, you know what I'm saying, continue doing so for this trip can be one of the most awesome trips of our lifetime. All right, so we're going to get into healing, health, and alternative cures tonight, Brother L. Let's touch on quite a bit of things here because most people don't know the real sciences and it's funny, every time we do one of these type of shows, we don't never have the audience in which that needs to be here because people rather hear about UFOs or some other bullshit like that, something always external of themselves as compared to, you know, learning the science of health and healing, you know what I'm saying, which is actually utilizing the power within.
Exactly.
You know, if you go to, they don't never want to really become God and goddess. You know, they always want something outside of themselves. You know,
exactly. Mm-hmm.
Right. So, you know, that's the thing in which that I notice about most people. You know, if I had a show about UFOs and shit, you know, we have over 150 people on here. You know, listening
yeah,
to that
right.
shit.
You're right, too.
You know, right. I mean, yeah. I mean, it's the truth, brother. You know, that's just the way it is. That's how people mentality, you know.
Yeah.
And then wonder why people are confused about the word metaphysics because they thinking that it's talking about some damn UFOs or something external to themselves all the time or something. And metaphysics has nothing to do with that. Metaphysics has to do with the power of the mind.
Right.
And how to utilize the mind to manipulate matter. Hence,
right.
First, the flesh. Hence, your physical universe. And then everything outside of that physical universe, you
mm-hmm.
know what I'm saying, which is still part of the universe itself. But it teaches you how to go into not just mastering of self, but also how to deal with the things in the environment, you know,
mm-hmm.
and in your community, you know, in your own backyard and et cetera. So, you know, these are the things in which that we have to definitely learn the science of. And like I said, I, you know, we was having a show you know, on UFOs or something. You know, we have over 150 listeners right now, you know, and callers, and people already have their hands raised, and I ain't even get into the subject yet, you know. But when it comes to alternative health and cures that the medical profession do not want you to know about, you know, it starts out slow.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. You know, we don't have that many people, because it seems that the people don't really want to learn the science of health. But it's funny, when I go and see Dr. Layla Africa, he has a room full of people. When I go see Dr. Sabi, room full of people. So people are really caught up into nostalgia. You know, they're caught into sensationalism. You know what I'm saying? They'll go to the most popular people, you know what I'm saying, or a person, or whatever the case may be. But, you know, when we teach the real science, holistic science, and we teach you the science of how to move the energy within your ethereal body, how to absorb the energy of the cosmos from the sun, from the star constellation Sirius, Orion, or et cetera, the Pleiadians, in particular the central sun, Alcyon, or whatever the case may be, people see that this is spookism. But yet, why you think that the ancient Egyptians was called sun worshippers? Because they understand the science of Qigong, or Tai Chi, as it is called now within the Orient.
Exactly.
You know, they knew the science of how to absorb energy and store the energy within the Dantians, you know, the lower, the mid, and the upper Dantians. So they knew how to store this energy. And with being, with the ability to store this energy, it made them stronger. It produced a longer life, because you're mixing cosmic energy with your own personal chi or ki energy, your own personal prana, your own universal life force energy personified. You know, this energy is what formed your physical body into existence, in which that gave the template of a child, you know, within the womb of the mother, from when the sperm head broke off, you know, and blew up to the equivalent size of, you know, the ovum, you know, or the, you know, nucleus of the egg, you know, and began to go through mitosis, or what it's called, and became a blastopore, you know. So, I mean, these are fantastic things in which that occurred, the life, or the, you know, the birthing process, and the crazy thing is that most people don't understand their own existence. You know, they don't understand that there was an ethereal template prior to the formation of the physical.
Right.
You know, and scientists have proven this through the Curlian camera, you know, in which that is able to take photographs, as well as also another means of methods. You know, so, I mean, these are real sciences here, and people have to learn how to respect them, you know, to the ultimate. And being that we're going into the fifth dimension, in which that deals with energy, and we're moving from out of the third dimension that deals with only length, width, and height. The fourth dimension deal with depth, or deal with what is called space and time. And the fifth dimension deals with energy. For those who are ready to deal in that arena, we're here, you know, because this is the real science of health, what we're talking about.
Right.
You know, it deals with the power of the thoughts. You know, thought travels 24 billion miles per second. Light travels 186,000 miles per second. Sound travels 1,120 feet per second. So each time we see that thought becomes light, light becomes sound, and sound forms geometrical shapes, patterns, modes, schemes, frequencies, vibrations. It is based on all of those particular modalities, you know, and energy modalities at that. So when you deal with energy modality, you tap into all of those particular things. You tap into sound, you tap into light, you tap into thought, you know. And, you know, we know that, you know, light is energy, and that we know that there's, like, tachyon energy, in which that actually travels faster than light.
That's right.
You know, tachyon energy actually can be basically equivalent to thought, you know. And if people go back and watch the movie K-Pax, you know, this is for, you know, the UFO people out there, you know, who want to talk about the UFOs and stuff, you know. But when you go back to the movie K-Pax, you'll find that in the beginning of the movie, he stated, because they asked him, how did he travel there, you know, to the Earth? And he said he traveled on a beam of light called tachyon energy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, us as melanated beings can tap into tachyon energy. You know, another equivalent to that is what is called dark matter or black energy. All right?
That's what
and these are the areas in which that we need to be studying. You know, when we talk about metaphysics, which is nothing more than quantum physics. You know, quantum physics, you know, we know that it's a new science in which that is part of physics. But quantum physics, the reason why it had to go beyond the physical, because metaphysics was answering all the questions. So it had to come in with a, you know, with a so-called science in which that you are able to get a degree in order to quantify that and to make that particular field acceptable amongst the masses. But they had to call it quantum physics. But really, that's all there is really metaphysics. That's all it is.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
You know, so when people get into metaphysics, we really have to understand what we are actually, you know, dealing with. And it's not anything spooky. You know, your physical body, you know, is something in which that exists. And there is a ethereal or a spiritual counterpart to it. There's no doubt about it. And once these things are understood, overstood, understood, then we can begin to start, you know, mastering these particular sciences. And one particular science is what's called pranic healing, in which that deals with three different modes, in which that deals with, number one, being able to scan the auric field, in which that the average person's auric field only extends about 3 feet outside of the physical body.
Mm-hmm.
So a person can actually walk up into another person's auric field if they have their hands out, feeling for the auric field and feeling for the density and for a particular sensation, you know, like a little push sensation. And when they have their hands out, they would feel for this push sensation, and they can begin to start examining the outer auric field of a person. Then they can go in about 1.5 feet and start tapping into what is called the health field or auric field of the person. Mm. And they can go in about 2 inches above the physical body, which is the inner auric field of a person. And they can seal up the leaks and the holes in which that is caused by ourselves, which is detrimental thoughts in which that we have, negative thoughts in which that we have, or other people's thoughts in which that could plague us, you know, which is negative thought forms in which that can become attached to our auric field. And so these things can actually be removed in order to help provide a healthy condition for the individual. So you will learn how to scan the person's auric field. Then you can do what's called sweeping, in which that you remove the negative debris, what is called bioplasmic energy, from the auric field. In other words, the crystalline negative energy or thoughts in which that has become trapped within the auric field, and you can remove that energy. And then you can do what is called energize, and you can strike an Egyptian pose or what is called Sumerian or Kemetic pose, and actually take the energy in which that is stored up within the environment or the atmosphere, in which that basically is what is known as, you know, we have the northern and southern lights, in which that's called aurora borealis, or, you know, the northern lights, as well as also there's the southern lights, in which that when this energy comes in through the north and south pole, the magnetic poles, that energy, you know, goes throughout the atmosphere, and a melanated person can absorb that energy. Matter of fact, 300,000 tons of stardust energy falls to the planet Earth daily. So there's plenty of energy to go around for everyone. And people would think that this is magic. And really, the only magic is the usage of the mind, which is the magic wand. And so you can will this energy into yourself and encapsulate it and capture this energy and store it within you in order to be used later on to transmit to others or to heal yourself. And so this is the science of pranic healing, you know, and so it behooves us to learn the science of pranic healing as well as also advanced pranic healing, in which that deals with being able to project. Once you learn the science of projection and how to energize a person's auric field and to seal up leaks and holes in their auric field and remove negative thoughts or debris from their auric field, then you will learn also at the same time to learn how to project positive energy, you know, such as the various colors of the Roy G. Biv or visible light spectrum. You know, for example, the red light symbolizes energy, you know, sexual passionate energy, in which that for a person who lacks, who are impotent or who has prostate problems or sexual frustrations or problems, then the red energy would be utilized for a short period of time Then, of course, you know, another color can be utilized, such as green or gold, all right, along with that red color. But the red gives you energy. You know, it energizes the physical body. And, of course, you have orange, in which that deals with nurturing. You know, not only do it nurture, you know, the physical body, you know, but it also is the storage place. The navel is the storage place, is what is known as the lower dantian, or the lower heaven, in which that energy can be actually stored within your belly button, about an inch and a half to 2 inches behind your belly button, you know, or below, you know, in that area. And that energy can be stored there, you know, to be transmitted later on or for your own usage. Matter of fact, if you learn the science of microcosmic and macrocosmic orbit techniques, which that you can learn from my grandmaster, Sunyata Saraswati, or from another master of mine, in which that is Mantak Chia, you can actually learn these particular exercises about how to do the macro and the microcosmic orbit technique, in which that you actually, once you store the energy, you can actually move the energy through your body, through your meridians, in particular the two main meridians, which is called your governing or functional and vessels, or what is known, also is known as your conceptional vessel. So you have a channel that goes up the back to the top of the head, and one that comes down the face, down the front of the body, back to the perineum. So you have these two particular channels. Actually, there's only one. This is what is known within the symbol, which that you can see within the occult, known as the Aurora Borealis, which is the serpent biting its tail. And how you close off that circuit is actually taking your tongue and placing it behind the upper teeth, right behind your teeth, right on that little area, right behind your upper teeth on your upper palate. And then also pulling up your anal muscles and perineum at that same time as you circle the energy up the spine. That's for the males. For the women, the channel of the energy will go up from the navel up to the head and down the spine to the perineum. So once you master these particular sciences, you're moving universal energy that you have captured through your body. And you're making use of this energy, and you're transforming that energy into personal energy. So hence, right, it extends your life. You begin to, you gain longevity, even immortality. All right? This is spoken of within the various scriptures and within the occult of how to maintain and gain immortality in the physical. And you'll be able to dematerialize and rematerialize at will. It's also referred to as gaining the golden dragon body before death, which you can do. Or after, when you pass, within 3 days of death, you'll resurrect and turn and transform your body into the golden dragon body.
Wow.
You know, so these are all sciences in which that you learn within the Tibetan, the Buddhist, the Shaolin, the Taoist, you know, the various occult fields. The Rosicrucians teach this information too. So this is not something in which that is per se hidden, but this is only learned in the higher orders. All right? I teach it because there is no secret any longer. We in the book of Revelation, so we here to reveal.
That's right.
You know, and
age of Aquarius.
Right, we in the age of Aquarius now, so you know, we're not dealing with that nonsense any longer. You know what I'm saying? You're either going to do the exercises, meditation techniques, breathing exercises, or you're not. It's just that simple. And
right,
the only ones who are going to be interested in doing it are those who have a sincere desire to master themselves.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? For those who are just curious, then you ain't got to worry about them. They're not going to practice the exercises anyway. So there is no need for the secret. Only ones who are going to practice are those who really want to do it.
Exactly.
You know? So these are real sciences here. You know, and people have to begin to start realizing it. You know? And so when we're talking about these particular exercises such as pranic healing, pranic healing actually is a form of qigong. You know, pranic healing is the name in which that comes from out of the Indo-Kush people, which are known as Tamil, or what they're known as the pre-Davidians, which are now referred to as the Sutra people, the people, the so-called black people or Moors from out of India. but they actually were the Kushite people, the Kushmores. And these are the sciences in which they brought from out of the interior of Africa as they went into India, or what is known as Hindu, or the Indo-Kush area. They, matter of fact, the Indo-Kush Mountains still exist to this very day. And you can ask any Indian about the Indo-Kush Mountains, and then they will have to tell you, well, you know, ask them, what do Indo mean? And what do Kush mean? And they will have to tell you that within the Sanskrit teachings, it means black.
Exactly.
So they know these particular sciences, but you have to, you know, you have to get at them about it, you know, and they will tell you the truth only once you get at them, you know, because
right.
they know this information came from you and your ancestry. So, and they know that they are simply holding it for you until you're awoken. You know, now that you have awake, you know, or have awoke, you know, now, of course, it's, you know, it's time for us to get back into it, you know, and take this information back and correlate the keys to the particular tribes. You have the Kong people from out of South Africa, in which that you have the such words as Qigong, Kung Fu, and so forth and so on. But the Kong people come from out of the interior of Africa.
Wow.
You know, the Kong people, you know, are the ones in which they put together the Kundalini. The Kundalini, or the Umbelini, as it is also referred to as. Talking about how to move that serpent or Nomo or Noom energy up the spine and down the spine is known as the fire.
Yeah.
That which makes you hot. You know what I'm saying? And the only reason why is feel like heat is because it's burning through ethereal threads. It's burning the threads of karma, you know, blockages, stagnated energy as it comes up through those particular chakras along the spine. Six in particular, and then one within the brain, which makes seven on average. Of course, there are some who have additional glands, such as the epiphany gland and such as the barytheric gland, in which that gives you nine chakras, as well as also we are developing into a 12-chakra being. So there's going to be three more glands in which that we begin to be grown within the body, all right, additional glands. So this is as we begin to open our minds more, begin to encompass more of the mind principle within us, which is known as the soul principle within us. And so giving you usage of more than just 2 to 10% of your brain, and that's really what you want. And so this is what these exercises actually do. And these memories or concentration of memories are passed on to your next generation. So that means when a child is born, they come out more aware than you were.
Exactly.
When you begin to start studying these particular exercises. You know, in other words, these are methods in order to learn how to bring gods and goddesses here to the planet Earth. You do this through channeling and conducting, transmitting, and primarily absorbing this cosmic energy. You know, so part of Qigong, we know that it's moving meditation. All right? Bodhidharma, from out of, who was a Tamil, pre-Dravidian, who came from out of the India or the Indo-Kush area, he went into the Orient. He went into China. And he seen the Shaolin monks falling asleep during meditation, you know. And so he developed what's called the 18 Hands of Lohan, in which that was Qigong movements, in order to awaken them, in order to give them meditation movements, you know, so they would not fall asleep. So that's why Qigong was beginning to start being used. But we know that if he was using it, you know, over 2,000 years ago, then we know that that information had to be further back, because we see on the walls of Africa, dating back to almost 3 to almost 4,000 years ago, Africans doing martial arts or particular combat and qigongs and you know, and different other movements, you know, on the walls, you know, of the you know, of ancient Egypt, what is known as Temeria or Kemet. So we know, and this also becomes part of what is known as Egyptian yoga, part of that same science. You know, so Qigong is very important because it teaches you how to utilize the energies in which that you absorb from the moving meditations, and then how to transmit or conduct those energies in order to heal others as well as also yourself. And then you have the symbols of Reiki, in which that are very powerful, in which that allegedly comes from out of Tibet. But really, These are Japanese symbols or letter scripts derived. And you would see that the word Reiki means universal life force energy. So really, it was dealing with the pranic and the qigong energy, because the word qigong actually means breath work or cultivating energy.
Mm-hmm.
So in order to cultivate your life force energy, it comes through the science of breath. All right?
Yes, it does. Yeah.
So, right. So once you learn how to master the science of breath, so a book in which that we recommend to get is The Science of Breath by Yoga Ramachakra. And when you read this book, study it, analyze it, practice the exercises in which that you can do at that particular time period. Also, another book in which that helps is called The Science of Pranayama, you know, by another yogi,
mm-hmm.
you know, and by practicing these particular breath techniques, you'll learn how to move this prana, this chi or ki energy. And so when we're dealing with Reiki, we have four symbols. We have Choku Rei, Seiheki, Hanshishi Shonen, Dekomeyo. And these four particular symbols acts as barrier between you and the person in which that you are healing, between their negative energy from being passed on to you. So when you use these symbols, they act as a barrier so that you will not absorb the negative energy. Unlike a person who just practiced pranic healing, or a person who just practiced, who's a shaman, you know, they run the risk of absorbing the negative energy, especially if you do not, within pranic healing, detach and cut the cord, the ethereal cord in which that is developed during the healing process, and which that normally you would do that at the end of the session. Now, a shaman is something similar to what you've seen on The Green Mile, when Michael Clark Duncan played John Coffey. When he played John Coffey, in which that he would absorb the negative energy of the person, the disease or ailment or sickness of the person, and then later on he would have to cast it off.
Right.
All right. Well, within Reiki, you don't have to worry about it becoming attached to you in order to cast it off, because the symbols are there, the letters or the symbols in particular are there in order to make sure that it do not become attached to you.
Right.
So, like, for example, Choku Rei is the symbol in which that you use in order to help heal the physical body. Seiheki is the symbol in which that is used to heal the emotional body. Hanshishi Shonen is the symbol in which that is used to heal the mental body. And Dekomeyo is the symbol used in order to heal the spiritual body. All right, so they understand that you are a multidimensional being also. And then all of this leads up to Tantra Kriya Yoga, as we was talking about. Tantra deals with expansion. So that's what Tantra actually means. It means to expand. So people think that it deals with just sex. No, it deals with talking about expansion of a consciousness. That's what Tantra is. It's teaching you how to expand more than just 2 to 10% usage of your brain, how to expand and tap into more usage of your mind. That's what this is really talking about. All right, so, you know, that's where we really need to go with this at and get more clarity on. All right, so when we're talking about these particular sciences, you also have to know that Tantra, Grandmaster Sunyata Saraswati, combined Tantra Yoga and Kriya Yoga. As we were saying, Kriya Yoga is the right-hand path. Tantra Yoga is the left-hand path. So he combined both paths, all right? And we was talking about the fact that his teacher was Yogananda, in which that actually gave him the Cobra Breath technique when he was 9 years old. And so, you know, now he's in his mid-70s, all right? Well, you know, upper 70s, actually, you know, let me see. When I met him, he was 69, and that was in 2005. That's what he told me anyway. Something that he's older than that, you know, but that's the age in which that he gave us, you know, for all we know, he could be 300, you know, with these mastering of these particular sciences and techniques, you know, with the breathing exercises, and then mastering with the Tantra and the Kriya Yoga methods, which of course, you can, Dr. Muwatta Ashby, he speaks about it. I think he got a book called Egyptian Yoga, in which that he also got one. I think he deals with Tantra Yoga too. Tantra. So when you study these particular philosophies and these particular exercises and sciences of the yoga. Yoga also means the union, all right, to unify. And it's talking about the lower and the higher self, how to union, how to bring forth. This is the ancient Egyptian or Kemetic or Tamaran, Nagu or Naga, Pharaoh Pharisees, in which that combined both crowns on the head. The white and the red crown. The red represents Set, which is lower Egypt, and white symbolizes Heru, which is upper Egypt, in which that you combine both within one crown. So hence, that is yoga or yoga, in which that means union. The word religion symbolizes the same word as yoga, in which that means to link or to connect, all right? So that's the same science with that. So we have to learn what all of this really means, all right? I'm going to have to go here in order to get back into the radio show because we got guests coming on. And so bear with me for a second as we try to get back on here. A lot of information we got to continue covering. And I know that we have some questions, so we're going to try to get back up in the studio. Once again, for those who want more information, please go to www.drlimelbey.com. That's DrAlimelbey. We have so much information on there until it's ridiculous. You won't come off of it. You'll be on there for days and weeks and months and years. All right? All right, for those who was in the chat room, we got the chat back up. All right, we're going to area code 706. Area code 706, you're on the line. Can you hear us?
How you doing, Bay?
Peace, bro.
Peace. And you going in. I love what you're talking about. I don't want to interrupt you. Would I be interrupting this show if I asked about I got an abscess, man, been bugging me, and I want to know the significance of the wisdom tooth. And I'm trying to figure out, should I take it out or just let it abscess? It abscess, it swollen up like a nail later, and then now it's going down because I end up getting some antibiotics because I couldn't stand. I didn't know which way I was going to go up. And I broke down and took two lower tabs, but now, you know, I just need to know the information from now on.
Well, number one, in order to help, number one, you have to stop brushing your teeth with black walnut, in which that preserves the enamel as well as also get rid of plaque and dis-ease. So it actually stops gingivitis, you know, which also is part of abscesses. So also some other cleansing herbs in which that you would want to use is burdock, yellow dock, chaparral, golden seal, myrrh. These particular herbs are actual antibiotics, you know, so instead of having to go and get them from the doctor, you can actually use those particular herbs, in particular golden seal. If you don't know what's wrong with your physical body, golden seal is like one of the all healing herbs in which that you can use, in which that is damn near good for everything because it is nature's antibiotic, you know. So those are the herbs that you definitely need. Go to our website and you can read in depth about herbology and what the herbs do. All right. I am degreed as a master herbalist under Dr. Paul Gulse, who is a international world-renowned herbalist and irisologist, as well as also from Emmanuel Bible College and Herbal Academy. I actually have a degree in herbology. So people definitely want to learn the science of herbology, because just in case you have to be in the woods, you know, you would know what plants in order to eat, how to identify them. Matter of fact, we have pictures of the herbs on the website. So people who want to go into not just herbalism, but also herbology and being able to identify and study the herbs, you can learn that information from right there off the website too.
Beautiful.
You have any other questions, brother?
As far as like getting swelling out, I had looked up some things called oil pulling. It comes from the pride. Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
Yeah. All pulling. It comes from the tribe. That tribe name is. Okay, it's spelled AYURVEDIC. And they suggested pulling coconut oil, sunflower seed, sesame seed oil through your teeth, and that'll helping them too, as well as make them white and get your gum back pink.
Right, right. You can do that. You can also use strawberries, in which that whitens your teeth. As we said, also black walnut, in which that also whitens the teeth and remove plaque and remove stains on the teeth. So coffee stained teeth and, you know, those types of things do not have to exist with the herbs in which that you would use on a daily basis. You know, so yeah, definitely, definitely. There's several remedies, you know, that you can definitely use.
And the significance of the wisdom tooth, would you think?
Wisdom tooth, the 32 teeth in your mouth actually symbolizes the 32 plus one vertebrae in your back. All right? Your teeth are directly correlated to your vertebrae, which are, you have 33 vertebrae. So your 32 teeth are symbolic to the 32 vertebrae plus one. Okay, so your wisdom teeth symbolizes you tapping into certain areas of the body. In particular, the wisdom tooth deals with the spinal column. And, of course, there's two poles to the spine. You have the north pole and you have the south pole. So you have the south pole, in which that deals with the genitals or, you know, what is known as your lower energies or lower mind or lower self. And you have the upper northern pole, in which that deals with, you know, your higher self, your higher mind, your higher nature. All right. So when your wisdom teeth come in, it symbolizes just that wisdom or the mastery over the lower energies. You know what I'm saying? That's what that actually is symbolic to. Metaphysics. That's why it's called the wisdom teeth.
Okay. Yeah, I just didn't see that going, getting it pulled out like that. I know I want to know how to work everything in my body.
Exactly. That's the key. That's exactly right. Now, there's another method in which that you can use too. You can actually rub your hand together like Mr. Miyagi did on Karate Kid, and then lay your hands on your jawline or the area of your wisdom tooth, and that itself would cause the abscess to pour out in order to shrink and also, you know, cause your teeth, you know, to become more comfortable with it coming, you know, with it being able to come in. And, you know, so you definitely want to do that too. You know, that's what is called pranic healing or Qigong or part of Reiki, if you utilize those symbols that we was talking about. So you definitely want to rub your hands together and place them on your jawline in order to, you know, heal that particular gum and tooth.
Okay.
Well, definitely.
Okay. And I do the alternate breathing, and I can say it really works. I get up in the morning and do my yoga stance and breathe in, alternate breathing, hold it, and I feel strong too. I feel strong. I don't really work out no more like I used to, but I just feel strong. I feel healthy. You know, it really, that energy that you say, pulling the starter, they're coming down. I try to get all I can.
Right. No doubt, no doubt. Well, that's the key, is the science of breath. And, you know, hopefully, you know, we can begin to start getting more people onto that, you know, real science, you know, and getting them from, you know, all these other, you know, distractions, you know, or the CIA disinformation and misinformation. You know what I'm saying, brother?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep. We got another. Yep.
But I want to also tell you, I'm sending that energy out and on that wonderful trip you got, and I'm definitely trying to
appreciate that.
Get in with
you. Appreciate that, brother.
Next year,
No doubt. Appreciate that.
Mm-hmm. All right, then, Bay. I love it, man. I love it. Keep doing what you're doing.
Appreciate that, brother. Thank you.
All right. Peace.
All right. We got area code 614. Area code 614. You're on the line.
Peace, brother. 614.
You're on the line. Peace.
Can you hear me? How you doing?
Yes, we can.
And
all right.
King L, right?
Yes, brother L is on the line. Yes.
Hey, everyone, guys. Well, I really didn't have a question. I'm out of Ohio, and I do Qigong and Tai Chi, but it's like the instructors are Eurozoids. And
right.
It's like I don't know if there are any references or contacts of anybody in Ohio that's melanated that teaches these classes.
I don't know anyone in Ohio right now, but I can definitely do some research. And if you want, you can hit me up on Facebook and
okay.
Just give me a few days and I can find out if there's anyone in that area, you know, of our people who actually practice and do those particular, you know, Qigong methods or Tai Chi methods and see what we can do for you.
Okay, great. Thank you so much, Aline.
Oh, you're welcome. Peace.
Peace.
Five one two, you're on the line. Area code 512. Brother L, you back with me? 314.
No, I'm not. I'm not online.
Yes, you are, brother.
I am.
Yes, you are.
Oh, okay. Because I got cut off a long time.
Oh, it's all right. We got cut off too. I got cut off too. So.
Okay, good. I didn't think I was back online. I kept on yelling your name, and you never responded. So I said, I must not be back online. So
right.
And I don't want to click back off because I might be way back in the host queue before you get
right.
back to me.
Right.
So okay then, I'm here.
All right. Just making sure, brother.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess they didn't like what we was talking about here.
Yeah,
you know, the real sciences.
Again.
Yeah. I guess they didn't like it, but right. You know, that's the key. You know, I guess they rather us talk about the chemtrails and the damage that it does instead of, you know, what you can do in order to reverse those effects or
right.
not to be affected and prevent. You know, the way, you know, the methods of prevention.
But
you
they
know,
don't want you to have no remedies.
Right. Well, you know, we know that the chemtrails does with on the respiratory system. And, of course, you know, there's herbs in which that you can utilize in order to help cure any or, you know, remedy any problem with the lungs, you know, mullein,
mm-hmm.
cold foot, you know, hyssop, you know,
mm-hmm.
cayenne pepper. You know, these are herbs in which that can actually remove mucus or excess of mucus from, you know, the body.
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
So.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, a lot of them, the reason why you don't hear a lot of people that be online, because when you talk about these kind of issues, because it's detrimental against their destructive eating habits and the life that they live.
Right.
You know,
and see, I haven't even gotten into the food. You know, we've been dealing with the real sciences.
And then that's what they don't want to hear, you know. And it's all, like you said before, it's already they want to hear about the UFOs and all this
right.
kind of nonsense, you know. But when you get talking about the health food and health issues and holistic health, then that's kind of, like I said, is detrimental against them and their lifestyle that they're living. And so instead of them trying to listen to what you're talking about, and something that can really be beneficial to them, you know. And I mean, you are already benefiting from it.
No doubt about it.
So, they're actually really working against themselves. Why?
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah, you're definitely right.
I guess maybe they don't
yep.
want to come into the fifth dimension, I guess. I don't know.
Exactly, right?
Exactly.
All right, we got area code 702. Area code 702, you're on the line. Peace.
My brother Peace. Aleem, how you doing there?
Peace, boy.
You doing well.
Yeah, hey, you know what, man? I appreciate y'all for keeping this whole conversation going on. No matter what the conversation is, it's not about everyday life, man. It's not about what's going on these streets. It's not about that, you know. I don't care about what you did last night. I don't care about no club. I don't care about none of that. How the fuck can we move forward, man? I'm tired of that shit, my bro.
Exactly.
Right.
You can't. How is it that the conscious community cannot the next motherfucker in the conscious community? There's no way you can tell me that that's legit, man.
Yep. Exactly, bro.
Accept people for what they believe in the conscious community, man. Because you know that you ain't fucking focusing on no motherfucking religion, man. It's the truth.
Exactly. Yep.
God damn, man. Last week I said something about some motherfucking motors and shit. I said the motherfucking rotor was the thing that was spinning inside of the motherfucking stator, man. But
right,
the
motherfucking, I remember.
Rotor don't move. The motherfucking stator moves around the rotor. But what I was saying
right.
was black people are the core of the motherfucking earth.
Right.
No
I
matter
remember.
How this motherfucker spin, we the ones that make it spin.
Right.
Right.
No,
but I've been
no
beating
doubt.
Myself up for that all week just because of the fact that you got people that's conscious that look at every word you saying like, he's wrong about that, this and that. Fuck if I was wrong, man. You know what the fuck I meant, nigga. Just like if I don't speak motherfucking eloquently, if I don't speak clearly, nigga, you know what the fuck I meant.
Right.
Let's not beat each other up, man, no more, man. Because when it all comes down to it, we all on a motherfucking same goal, nigga. But we on different tracks. Just like a motherfucking mouse running to the cheese. You put a million different mouses to chase that motherfucking cheese. They all on a whole nother track.
That's
but
right.
they all trying to get to
well,
the same motherfucking piece of cheese, man.
Yeah, so you're
right.
Right,
well, you know what it is. Yeah, I mean... you know, that's the thing. They always want to pick out some type of flaw, you know,
look,
like, for
I'm
example,
for
I was talking
about... look for the positivity in this shit, man.
Right.
We all passionate,
right, right.
man.
Right.
You come with your package because, let me say, if the knowledge was food, which it is, let's just say it's actual food that we can eat. If it's all food and everybody's starving and everybody needs the same nutrition to survive, let's just say we got a cap and the whole world is fucked off. Let's just say everybody in the conscious community, let's say it's about a million of us, but the world is filled with billions. The billions of these motherfuckers in the world is sick and fucking fucked off. But everybody that got knowledge have what we need to survive. You're telling me the
and
food that you bring from your habitat ain't going to help me?
Of course.
Even if your food ain't fully nutritious, but your shit is organic, right? You bringing that shit
That's
to the
right.
table, nigga, because we all surviving off the same motherfucking plate.
That's right.
Everybody else eating chicken nuggets and all this shit from McDonald's or whatever, and they dying, nigga. But we all got this knowledge right here to get us through, because when it boils down to it, it's like Voltron. We all the same body.
And that's the truth of the matter, bro.
I'm tired, man. I promise you, my love, I'm saying I'm tired, man. I'm tired of people that have come across. First of all, you know good and well that most of the black people you come around don't know about Osiris, Osar, whatever name it was on the Egyptian wall, because I'm not going to listen to what they say his name was. Because we ain't even saying that shit right. You ain't
right.
even know how the hell they said that shit. That shit,
right.
man. They could have been saying that shit. That nigga name could have been Doo Doo. That shit could have been, his name could have been shit. But because they say Osar, that's how they pronounce that shit. You don't know what that motherfucker's name is. You calling anybody a name that's probably not even,
That's like a motherfucker called your name. Your name is Eileen. A motherfucker could be saying, be calling you by some motherfucking old bullshit. If a motherfucker called you by a name that's not Eileen, you feel disrespected.
Right.
You don't know what that motherfucking Walmart is really saying, man.
Right. Well, that's what that's what Professor Walter Williams say.
Exactly.
Right. Now, of course, interpret it a little bit different, that I know that there's Africans within Africa that still speak Metuneta in some shape, form, and fashion, and that a lot of the languages that's spoken in Africa right now is at least 60 to 90 some odd percent actual Metuneta. You know,
exactly.
So the thing is that we got to get, with these particular tribes like the Akan, allegedly they are actually speaking almost 98% Metuneta. So it would behoove us that we learn Akan, that particular language, which is part of the Ifa system.
It's called Akan.
Yeah, Akan, A-K-A-N.
Akan.
And this was correlate with John Henry Clark, as well as also Dr. Ben Yakinen, in which that stated that there was Africans that came from the east and then journeyed into the west of Africa. But I appreciate you, bro.
Hold on,
go to the line here. We got more calls.
My brother, go to that line, but let me just say one thing before you bring that call in. Well, bring the call in at the same time. I'm going to tell you like this. When you look at Africa for what it is during these times, the savior that go through and feed all the African people and go through and act like it's all love and all this is a motherfucking European, man. I'm going to tell you all this knowledge that we soaking up, man. Behind that knowledge, it's a white boy standing there, man. You can't tell me that the people in Africa know the method, man. There's no way that I'm convinced by that.
Now we're not talking about the whole culture.
Right.
We're not talking about a vast amount of Africa. Remember now, Africa is actually more than five times the size of the United States. So we think that the United States is large. We're talking about five times the size of the United States.
Right.
You can actually fit the United States.
Africa's a giant, man. And you're right.
You're
definitely right.
Right. So we're not talking about, of course, remember the tribes that they keep showing us are the ones who are always butt naked, and they don't never show us the city. They don't never show us, the other tribes in which that existed. So, you can have hundreds and thousands of tribes within Africa, today, in which that the Europeans still have not come in contact with because of
how large. Yeah, my brother, man, hey, first of all, let me apologize, man. I'm just angry, man. But I know that some knowledge, it got so much depth. I'm so angry, man, that, I might be a whole lot closer to the surface than you, man. So just put me on mute and let me listen, man.
All right, I appreciate you, man. Thank you for taking time out to get on with us.
Don't hang up on me, man. Just let me listen. Put me on mute.
All right. We got area code 540. Area code 540, you're on the line.
It was good, Dr. Lee and Brother L. How y'all doing?
All right, fine. Brother,
doing
how you
good,
doing,
bro? How are you?
I'm doing real good. First, I just want to say, man, I appreciate the brother's enthusiasm. Even if you're wrong or right, we don't get that kind of energy enough these days, period.
No doubt.
Exactly.
I'm glad he's enthusiastic. I wanted to ask you a question about as far as you saying something about removing, maybe your own, negative thoughts and stuff. Because, I still go to work 9 to 5, and I know everybody in my job. I work in a big building, I know everybody in my job and got my best interests at heart because, I kind of stick out, if you know what I mean.
Right.
So I just wondered, what's the kind of way to, maybe, at the end of the day, get that, maybe that negative energy off of
right.
Me.
Well,
know,
before you go
to,
in,
go ahead.
Right. Before you go into work, you want to do a prayer or decree you know, some type of positive affirmation prior to going in, garb yourself in white light. White has a tendency of repelling or rejecting or, you know, negative energy.
Okay.
You know, or you can even do gold light, which that is a, which is so high of a frequency, the majority of the people there can't even tap into that frequency.
Okay.
You know, so these are the colors that you would use on an everyday basis. And then after you leave, you can actually take a 20-minute bath and soak in Epsom salt or sea salt, you know, and just remove the negative debris from around your auric field.
Okay.
You know,
I'm going to ask you about the ground and thing, like what I can do.
Right, you can do Qigong in which that you can actually – right, you can do Qigong in which that you can actually take your hands and take them and you will actually move them out from outside up towards over your head and then bring your hands down with the fingertips almost touching in front of you down the front of your body.
Okay.
And you would actually just take the negative energy and then just release the excess of it into the ground or into the earth.
Okay.
So your hands would go out,
like
up.
Barefoot or something like that?
Yeah, you can do it barefoot or either have socks on or, you know, something in which that don't have too much rubber.
Okay.
Because rubber has a tendency of cutting off about 35 to 50% of the ground energy.
Gotcha. Okay. All right, well, appreciate that. I'll probably hit you on Facebook about, because I've been trying to do a little Tai Chi stuff. I kind of taught myself, just looking online.
No doubt.
Nothing big or serious,
right.
But just finding somebody in my area
right.
that maybe does that. It looks like,
right.
you know, melanated. But appreciate it, brother. Y'all be easy, be safe.
Right, whatever you call, whatever you in, brother.
I'm in Virginia. I'm in southwestern Virginia. I don't know Virginia, to be honest.
Okay.
Yeah, we got
all
to try
right,
to do a
right.
conscious community up here.
Yes,
all right. No
I'm working, brother.
All right. I appreciate you. Peace. We get area code 708. Area code 708, you're on the line. Area code 708. Let's get him on here one more time. Here's 708.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Hear
peace.
I can hear you. Peace, boy.
Peace. This is Troy, better known as Coach Chief, calling from Chicago. What's good with y'all tonight, man?
All right. Peace, Brother Troy. Good to have you, bro.
Peace, Brother Troy.
You know, one thing I noticed is, man, you know, I've heard a lot of people say, sometimes I laugh, but you ever heard somebody call somebody a smart, dumb motherfucker?
Right.
So the reason I say that is, you know, I've been looking into the health and the nutrition and the wellness for years, but what's irritating to me is when you're trying to do your thing, but there's like six or seven different theories on the same thing that you're doing. So I had, you know, I was in New York this weekend for the Nityama event with Brother Polite, and I was standing in the line talking to a young goddess. And she basically telling me that you can't have too much alkalinity in your diet. True, you need balance, but there's also acid that comes from natural products of the earth.
Right,
so she's literally telling me about a book that states you have to eat scientifically. And I'm not going to put the brother's name out there that wrote the book because I'm familiar with him. But the brother is basically saying, you have to eat lamb so that you can get certain things from the lamb, and you got to eat this, and you got to eat this. And this is all flesh food and all cooked food that causes a lot of different gases, a lot of different mucus. But it's to the point now, man, where the people are so confused that they're willing to jump on any insanity that sounds right to them just so they can stay in their comfort zone.
I know.
You know
right,
what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Now, I'm a brother. I'm known.
And I know the brother that you're talking about.
Okay. Now, I'm a brother that get up twice a day and juice. And I'm the type
right.
of dude that I'll go 3-4 weeks just juicing. That's how
right.
mentally ill I'm into it. so, you know, and I'm always looking for ways to sharpen, you know, say my passion for it. But, I mean, it's even to the point, if you want to talk astrology, and I study, I love astrology, I study, but now you got people telling you, like, you know, the first day of spring is 2 weeks ago, it's 2 weeks from now. And I'm like, dude, the first day of spring is today, March 20th.
Right, right.
But people so smart and dumb at the same time, they telling me spring starts 2 weeks from now. And I'm like, man, has it come to that point now where consciousness has become such a fad that if you read any knowledge without doing any type of background reference check, get 5-6 different books that say the same thing, kind of check up, you know, do that type of knowledge. But just don't gravitate to anything just because it sounds good and you want to sound good when you talk to your friends. You know what I mean? It's like ridiculous, man.
Bruh, I mean, you saying what needs to be said. That is the reason why we have tonight's show, is because of the idiotic nonsense in which that has been going on in the conscious community concerning the real science of health, healing, and alternative cures, you know, in which that what you're talking about is, yes, there is people jumping on the bandwagon of this brother, and I'm talking about they can eat lamb and white bread and all types of shit.
Yes, I'm talking about the book even said you're supposed to. Now, I know you know where I'm coming from, bro. You need the natural enzymes within the natural foods. Hell,
right.
There are even some
right.
natural foods that are grown that you're not even supposed to process as a melanite, like carrots, like grapefruit.
Right.
But, you know, I love grapefruit, but there are certain foods I'm going to stay away. But when I was appalled when I heard that this person said in the book, you're supposed to eat croissants and other things because it has certain enzymes in it that you can't get from herbs. I was like, are you kidding me right now saying this? You're kidding me. You're actually saying this?
Man.
Where's a croissant grown at? Please tell me where
they
grow croissants.
Right.
And you would think people would have, you know what I'm saying? And the first thing I do, I don't want to judge.
But you know what that is, right? You know what that is, brother, is that the fact is that he has a $4,000 machine in which that can show the enzyme levels of food. So, therefore, you know, that's what they're jumping on. So, you need enzymes because that's the catalyst in which that make the vitamins, that move the minerals, you know, in which ignites the vitamins to convert it into energy in the cells and blah, blah, blah. You know, that's what's going on, bro. You know.
Man, I mean, it's
course,
all across the board. It's even... It's across the board everywhere, and it's to the point, man, where it's like everybody's taking shots at each other. Everybody is undercutting each other. You know, one person is saying this. The other person want to piggyback with the other person because they feel better with somebody. You know, it's just like, man, dude, it's just disappointing in a way. But when I sit and I talk to people, and I don't toot my own horn, I just do what I do, and I'm passionate about health. But when I got somebody telling me that I need to eat meat because there's certain things in meat that you can't get from fruits and vegetables, I'm like, man, if you don't get out my face right now, man, like, I don't even want to talk to you right now. You're telling me I shouldn't eat kale salad. I can't eat a kale salad and feel good about it. I need to have me a piece of meat, maybe because you can't do it and I can. I mean, come on, dude. I go weeks just juicing and not chewing anything.
Exactly.
That's bad for you. I think like Nityama said, man, people need to put themselves in uncomfortable situations purposely so that they can actually experience growth instead of always wanting to be comfortable so that, you know, they won't have to deal with some of the situations that are, you know, put them in a bag like, man, how do I get out of this? There's no experience in that if you're going to stay comfortable. I don't know, man. I love my conscious community, but it's to the point now you need to come up with another term to actually describe those people that actually are all about it and not doing it because it's a fad.
Right.
I agree. Well, that's one of the reasons why many don't want us to use the word metaphysics, because that actually makes you overstand the signs of the human anatomy and then also what works and moves the physical anatomy, what operates it. You know, what is this energy within us in which that make us wake up in the morning? You know what I'm saying? You know, we saying, oh, God woke me up this morning. Okay, well, you know that's your parasympathetic nervous system. You know what I'm saying? You know, your involuntary nervous system. You know what I'm saying? And you have two. You have your voluntary nervous system, which is your sympathetic nervous system, and you have your involuntary nervous system, your parasympathetic nervous system. And they work in conjunction in order to regulate the function of your body. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
You know, so when you begin to start analyzing the human anatomy, you know, it answers the questions instead of us putting everything off on some spooky shit.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And, you know, and so, I mean, so when these people get into, like you said, the science of health, you know, like you said, they want you know, someone to tell them that they can go and do those particular things. You know, go and eat lamb. You know, go and eat some goat. You know what I'm saying? You know, they want someone to tell them these types of things because they can go and do it. You know, the Muslims, you know, they got some, you know, you go to New York, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. They got some halal trucks right there, which is you can get lamb and goat right off the truck.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? $6
wow.
a plate.
Man.
You know, so, you know, they want people to, you know, tell them these. That's why I deal with the science of energy. You know what I'm saying? So regardless on, you know, on the diet, you know what I'm saying, whether we're dealing with Dr. Layla Africa, Dr. Sadie, Queen of Fua, Dr. Naughty, or whoever the case may be, nah, I'm dealing with energy. So therefore, anything that you're saying concerning the diet is just that. Die. You know what I'm saying?
So
I'm dealing with living
energy.
You know what I'm saying? I'm dealing with living energy. I'm living with living. Live it. You know what I'm saying? Instead of diet, I'm dealing with live it. You know what I'm saying?
Well,
so I don't have to get into those types of debates.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Between
exactly.
You know, which one you think is right. You know, is Dr. Sabi right over Layla Africa, or is Dr. Naughty right, or is Queen of Fool right with the fasting? I don't even have to get into those debates. You know what I'm saying? When I teach you the science of healing, the energy within you, then that's what you will have to contend with. That's what you have to become responsible with and for. You know what I'm saying? And so these are the things in which that, you know, people have to understand and understand and understand. But go ahead, brother. What you getting ready to say?
Okay, so another thing that a lot of confusion is on, we're still on the same subject, but of course we know that the more pure organic, the more alkaline that a product from the earth is, the more energy that it
is more electrical
to give you. Exactly.
Right, more raw,
but
more
now,
electrical, and so therefore. Mm-hmm.
In the spirituality realm, there's a lot of discussion about you can do some type of prayer to ask to not be connected to the negative energies within some of the processed food so that you won't feel sluggish and so that you won't feel like, you know what I'm saying, you are just being bared down because you're eating something that's not supposed to be in your body. What's your thoughts about that? Where now you have the spiritual realm.
Number one, that's a cop-out too, especially if they don't know how to store energy within their body. That's what we teach, and that's what we're talking about. You have three dantians, in which that is known as your lower, mid, and upper dantian, in which that if you absorb enough energy within your navel chakra, then that extends your life force. If you absorb it within the back of your heart, you know what I'm saying, then that extends or expand your love, and if you do it in your third eye or right above the third eye eyebrow area, then you deal with the expansion of your intelligence or higher IQ, as they would say. So you can store energy of prana or chi or ki energy into these particular areas in order to expand. In particular, if you want to expand your life force, then you would absorb it, like we said, in your lower dantian. So in that way, you can transmute the negative energies, you know, in which that one has ingested. However, why do that? Why not just eat the right foods? Why not just eat raw electrical foods? You know what I'm saying? If you can, eat raw, eat a salad, you know, on a daily basis, you know, colorful salad, you know what I'm saying? With kale, with spinach, with, you know, onions, you know, tomatoes, you know, with everything that you possibly can, you know, which is dealing with, you know, something dealing with organic or living. You know, because that's what the word organic actually means. It means living. You know what I'm saying? So why not eat right so that when you absorb these energies, you know, you're dealing with them at the highest level instead of to have to transform negative into positive when you can just, you know, add on to the positive in which that you have already doing. You know, so That's a very important key too, brother, what you're talking about. I definitely agree with you.
Yeah, because like I said, it's to the point, man, where everybody's coming up with their theories. And it's kind of sad because it's like, are these people actually trying to teach the masses, or is it all about getting money?
I think it's more so about getting money, brother. Because that's what I'm saying. When we teach on these health issues and these in particular sciences, you know what I'm saying, it's rare that we get over 20 to 30 callers, man. You know what I'm saying? Online, that is. You know what I'm saying? But when we teach on some UFO shit or some conspiracy theories, oh, man, we got over 150 callers online. So, you know, people are still dealing with external shit.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? They love, you know, they still waiting for white Jesus to come out the sky. Now they waiting for aliens to come on the damn ship. Cool. Now they waiting for something in order to save them. They always wait for something to save them other than the damn selves.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
And so therefore, they don't know how to take responsibility for themselves. They don't know how to take responsibility for their own health. They don't know how to take responsibility for their own psyche. They don't know how to take responsibility for their own spirituality. They don't know how. And most of them care not to, because they rather put it off on something spooky or something external of themselves. You know what I'm saying? And in thus doing so, they become idol worshippers. And if they go to the extreme, then they become anti-crisis.
Right.
Because they become detrimental against their own Christ consciousness.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? So this is the nonsense which has been perpetrated upon amongst the people. And as long as they don't know that God is within me, you know what I'm saying, and within them, then they will not gain full consciousness. They will always be playing, you know, that so-called conscious game, as I call it. You know, right now, son, you straddling the fence.
Peace, Dr. Ali.
Yes, peace.
Peace, brother.
Hey, peace, one more
thing.
Mm-hmm. I was just going to say one more thing. Can you just, and this is my last statement, can you just touch upon why they put the Argentinian priest or Argentinian Pope in the Vatican instead of letting Peter get it?
Yeah, well, real simple. They really felt like the people were not ready yet, even though Obama sit at the helm. What happened is that actually the day after he got in, the international courts actually issued a international warrant against him on March the 13th. So as soon as he got in, the international courts already issued a warrant against him. So we don't really know how long he's going to be in. And plus, he's already 76 years old. So more than likely, Peter will have to get in there sooner or later. Okay?
Right.
And see, that's why they had to use a Jesuit priest, because he was part of the Jesuits. All right? Now, Peter, if you ever see a picture of Peter, in which that we have, he was actually like the right-hand man to Hans of Valk. Right, the Black Pope. And he was like the right-hand man to him. You know, so, you know, that would be, because what we also found out that Hans Wartenbach is no longer the Black Pope. He's now no longer over it. So the thing is to find out who is now running the Black Popery. Because even on the news, they said that the Black Pope, who is the head of the Jesuit priest, has just as much power as the so-called White Pope. Now, they said this shit on CNN on the day that the so-called White Pope got elected. So they know who got the power. You know, so it's real interesting, and we're going to see how everything works out. You know what I'm saying? It ain't over. Because, see, what they was trying to do is stall on the prophecy. Based on the prophecy of Malachi, he stated that if the Black Pope gets in which that he predicted would actually get in, that it would actually be the end and the fall of the Catholicism. Everyone know that the popery is falling. There's no doubt about it. They are falling. And this former pope, Benedict, just got indicted for 25 years, along with the Queen of England and the Prime Minister of Canada. 25 years in jail. So all of a sudden, they sick, and now they can't be in the limelight and all this other thing, because they just got indicted for 25 years. And there was warrants.
So
this is a real court. Yeah, this is a real court. It's in Belgium, in Brussels, Belgium.
Oh, yeah.
And actually, this is where we're going to have to start taking these corrupted officials at in the United States, too, at an international level as being indigenous people and based on the Declaration of the Rights of Indigenous People coming from out the United Nations. And if
exactly.
you notice, if the United Nations is working in cahoots with these people as we think they are to that extent, then why would Canada deny the human rights the human rights person from the United Nations from coming in and checking Canada and the Native Americans who are there, you know what I'm saying, about their human rights and about their violations? Why would they stop the United Nations person from coming in? You know what I'm saying? That's what Canada just did about 3 or 4 days ago.
Yeah.
All right? So we know that there's something else is going on. There's other people who are actually do not agree with the New World Order. And so you will find more information popping up, such as this so-called White Dragon sect coming from out of China, in which that supposedly want to go against the Illuminati and do not care for the Illuminati. So we'll see what's continue going on. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
There's things in which that is happening in which that once we begin to analyze, just doesn't make any sense. You know, in other words, there are people who have awoke and they are also at the international scene or on the international scene making things happen too.
Right.
All right. All right. Hopefully that answered the question, brother. All right, we got area code 614. Area code 614, you're on the line.
Okay, this is me again. Andrea called earlier about Tai Chi Qigong. And I know that we previously just talked about because I done been through Queen of Fua and everybody,
right.
You know. I like panic say, you can try it yourself and see where it takes you. And
right.
even got your advice about using the burdock for, because I battle with eczema. And
right.
I do notice that the particulates for that one guy, it worked for me.
Right.
So it's like you got to just take a piece of everything and, you know.
Right.
And
right. Well, that's right. That's the key, too, is what's worked for you. Because everybody have a different biological system. We all have different blood types. You know, you might be O blood type. You know what I'm saying? And then you have to deal with being negative or being plus. You know what I'm saying? Then, of course, you have the other blood types that evolved from out of O blood type. You had A blood type, you know what I'm saying,
okay.
which is O blood type. Let's go through this right quick about the blood types because people also have to understand that there's science in that too, is that O means original blood. And this blood dates back to over 200,000 to almost 300,000 years ago. And O negative is the original blood type. All right, and so then, of course, from out of O blood type comes O positive, in which that O blood type means that they are universal donors. That means that O blood type can be used by any other blood type, AB, you know what I'm saying, blood types, you know, and they'll survive. But none of those blood types can be used by O blood types. All right, so then, of course, you have Agarian, which is A blood type, which dates back to about 13 to 20,000 years ago. Then you have B blood type, in which that dates back to about 6,000 to 13,000 years ago. Then you have AB blood type, which dates back to about 2,000 years ago. So if you get the book, How to Eat Right for the Four Basic Blood Types, there's some information in there in which that people can also, gain from, which is called, is by Peter Diamanto. So, I mean, anywhere in which that you can gain knowledge, then do so.
Mm-hmm.
And then try everything based on what you have gathered, you know what I'm saying, from your own common sense. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's what we can tell people. But for me to sit here and say, well, you know, who's the greatest, Layla Africa or Queen of Four or Dr. Naughty or Dr. Sadie, you know, I mean, that's, you know. And that's the right. And we'll see, but that's the debate in which that is going in the conscious community, though. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
And that's what the brother is upset about is that, you know, everybody is talking about, you know, what's the greatest and what's the – no, just like what you were saying, learn from all of them, get what you can, put your own system together and see what works for you. You know what I'm saying? Now, the problem that the brother had is because there's people who might not have even done that, but yet they're out teaching other people these particular systems from the people, you know, from these particular four people that we are talking about.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? But yet they have not done their own research. They have not sat down and did like you have done, and they have not taken the particulates. They have not taken, they have not done the fasting. They have not done the raw electrical live foods. They have not done, you know what I'm saying, these types of things.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's all.
So, I mean,
what works for you throughout all of them and
exactly.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And that's the key. Build your own system. That's the science. What makes you healthy? What's, you know, what makes you feel energized? What works for you?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So everybody has a purpose. You know what I'm saying? So we can't negate a person's purpose, but there are things in which that there are always alternatives, you know, like for a person who, like for example, back in the days, they were saying, well, vegetarians don't get enough vitamin B12. Well, people don't realize that there's B12 in dandelion. There's B12 in yellow dock. There's B12 in spirulina. There's B12 in corolla. There's B12 in sea moss. There's B12 in kelp. There's B12 in bladderwrack. You know what I'm saying? So when people were saying, you know, there's certain vitamins that vegetarians don't get and blah, blah, blah. Well, if you ate the right foods, then you would. So that's the key, too, is also eating the right combinations of foods, you know, and the combinations of herbs, you know. So there's a lot of information in which that we still analyzing, and this is why the conscious community is confused now over diet, and that's why we'll speak about diet, we'll speak about foods coming from a GMO process, coming from an organic process, a raw, live food process, electrical food process, you know, unprocessed, as we would say, uncooked food. But more so, we talk about energy, you know what I'm saying? Because we know that we are energetic, we have an energetic body. And this is the thing in which that the people are not being tapped into. And these are actually the body in which that a lot of these brothers and sisters in which that we have made mention of, you know, do not go in depth about. They do not talk about the energetic body. They do not talk about, on a large scale, the chakra system. They do not talk about how to absorb the energies of the sun, which is the primary source of energy.
Mm-hmm.
They always have us thinking about secondary things, such as food, water. When I got proof of breatharians, you know what I'm saying, actually absorbing water from the air, absorbing prana from the sky, and surviving for months and years on just that.
First World Order Radio, finally, we are on the air, no doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that Buddha consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Seen in others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Proceeding in others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right.
need to know our intentions straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages for us to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories, shit that works.